This is FFA Poultry Judging, Class 7, Interior Egg Quality. This is grade AA quality. To properly candle an egg, we take the egg and put the large side straight into the aperture where the light is coming out. We never turn the egg on its side because you cannot see the air cell. This is the proper technique, and you can clearly see the air cell. Because this air cell is very small, 1/8 of an inch or less in depth, it is a AA quality egg. Next, spin the egg while up to the aperture, watching the yolk go around inside the egg. Do this from both ends of the eggs and look for blood spots or meat spots. If there are none, then grade the egg by the size of the air cell. As the egg sits in storage, the larger the air cell will become. As we look at this egg, we can see that it is an A grade because the air cell is between 1/8 of an inch in depth and 3/16 of an inch in depth. Students should practice looking at air cells with a ruler to master the ability to judge the grade based on the depth of the air cell. Next, as with the previous egg, it is spun and the yolk is watched to ensure there are no blood or meat spots. If there are none, then the grade is based on air cell depth. There are no blood or meat spots in this egg. It is an A grade. As the egg is stored for even longer periods, air will seep into the air cell, making it larger. This egg has deteriorated to a grade B egg because the air cell is larger than 3/16 of an inch in depth. When this egg is spun, it looks like there is a possible blood spot. However, this is dirt on the surface of the shell and does not move when the egg is spun around. Because there are no blood or meat spots in this egg, this is a grade B egg. Notice the dirt spot there. Students should consider three yolk factors when evaluating egg quality: the yolk size and shape, the distinctness of yolk shadow outline, and yolk defects and germ development. The yolk of a freshly laid egg is round and firm. As the yolk ages, it absorbs water from the albumen and increases in size. This weakens the vitellin membrane and gives the yolk a somewhat flattened shape on top and a general out-of-round shape. The yolk membranes and tissues have weakened, causing the yolk to appear definitely enlarged and flattened. That would be a B-quality egg. There are three factors that govern the distinctness of the yolk outline or shadow outline: thickness and consistency of albumen. The thicker the albumen, the less distinct the outline. The condition of the yolk. The presence or absence of blemishes showing up before the candling light as dark shadows in the yolk determines its condition, and the color of the yolk. Except for off color, yolk color is difficult to determine when candling. However, extremes in yolk color may influence the candler's judgment of egg quality. There are 3 degrees of distinctness of yolk shadow outline. Outline slightly defined. That means the yolk outline is indistinctly indicated and appears to blend into the surrounding white as the egg is twirled. That would be AA quality. Outline fairly well defined. The yolk outline is discernible, but not clearly outlined as the egg is twirled. That's A quality. Or outline plainly visible. That means the yolk outline is clearly visible as a dark shadow when the egg is twirled. That's B quality egg. The yolk defects are defined as follows. Practically free from defects, this means the yolk shows no germ development but may show other very slight defects on its surface. This is for both AA and A quality of eggs. Serious defects, the yolk shows well-developed spots or areas and other serious defects, such as olive yolks, that do not cause the egg to be a loss egg. This would be considered a B quality defect. Clearly visible germ development. Development of the germ spot on the yolk of a fertile egg has progressed to the point where it is plainly visible as a definite circular area or spot, but with no blood in evidence. This makes the egg a B quality. Finally, when blood caused by development of the germ in a fertile egg appears as definite lines or as a blood ring, this is considered a loss egg. Terms to describe the egg white: clear. The white is free from discoloration of foreign bodies. This would be for AA and A qualities. It's important for students not to misinterpret a prominent chalaza as a foreign body. The egg white may be firm, where it's thick enough to prevent the yolk outline from being more than slightly defined when the egg is twirled. That's a AA quality. Reasonably firm, the white is somewhat less thick than a firm white, and that would be an A quality. It could be weak and watery. The white is weak, thin, and lacking in viscosity, and this is a B quality. Blood spots or meat spots, if the spots are small, aggregating not more than 1/8 inch in diameter, the egg is B quality. If large or showing diffusion of blood into the white surrounding a blood spot, the egg is a loss egg. It may have a bloody white. The egg has blood diffused throughout the white. Freshly laid eggs may have this condition. This is a loss egg. This is an excellent example of an egg with a blood spot. A blood spot smaller than 1/8 of an inch in length makes the egg a B grade, whereas a blood spot that's larger than 1/8 of an inch makes the egg a loss egg.